Hey everyone, Blake LaGrange here from mastering.com. Today we're chatting with Mark Haddon, and in this video we're going to take a look at how he was able to get the confidence in himself to actually start his own mastering business. So let's take a look. Before we dive into anything, man, I know you, I know your background, I know what you're up to, but for those who don't know you and what you're about and your background and all this, give sort of a general high-level kind of context for who you are, what you do.
I'm basically just a self-employed producer / mixer / engineer, and I'm just working out of a small home studio. I've only been doing it for a short time. Before that, I used to be a musician. I'm still a musician, I should say used to. and played in many bands and did a bit of touring and then started getting into the sound side of things. So doing a bit of live mixing. I started that through church. So that's where I kind of got into that. I've been the creative coordinator for our church's worship team for the last, or not for the last year, but before that, 6 years before that. And then, so that kind of got me into that producing kind of mindset. Yeah, since then I've just been teaching myself, learning how to mix and just doing lots of tutorials and kind of, yeah, very independently learning what I can and getting, I think I'm getting better and better and just want to take things to the next level.
Got it. So that's the context. That's who you're at or what you're doing and all of this and so and where you're at. Right before you and I chatted and you dove in, I'm curious to know, and just for some context, where, I guess if you could, share where you were in terms of just your mastering process, your mastering outcome, what you knew about it, what you didn't know about it. I mean, obviously, we'll go into what the process has been like for you as you dove in, but what was the catalyst for you to sort of dive in and say, okay, I need to do something about this?
I think the big catalyst with me was that I got asked to master something for a friend, and he knew that I was getting into this side of things, and yeah, just really wanted to give him a good product and was struggling to get what I thought was, you know, Grammy quality and good enough for him. And just really wanted to be I was just doing what I thought mastering was rather than what it actually is or what it should be. And yeah, I just wasn't happy with the end result. So that was kind of the catalyst for me to go, I've got to get better at this.
And you take yourself and your craft very seriously, as I've come to find out, which is awesome. So now let's dive into it. So we had a conversation, had a great chat, and it was like, okay, I totally see how this would be a good fit. And then you dove in. What's it been like? What'd you found most helpful? What's happened since then? I mean, what's the transformation like? What are some eye-opening things? What are you going through right now? I mean, just everything kind of open-ended.
Yeah, well, now I just feel a lot more confident in what I'm doing on the mastering side of things. I feel like I can hear things better, especially the frequency range is just opening up for me. Like I'm listening to songs differently. I'm listening to the mixes differently. I'm listening to everything from want this to be on the radio type mindset rather than, oh, yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, right.
So, yeah, and just with all the content that I've had from you so far, I'm just learning heaps and just applying it to what I'm doing and yeah, straight away seeing results. So it's just great.
That's awesome, man. And so, I mean, I already know this, but it seems like you've taken the plunge into where you're basically have gone through week three and you're like, okay, I got to do something about my room. Mm-hmm. So share that experience. What are you up to right now in terms of how the process is working, where you hit a wall because, okay, I need to address this. What were the things that you sort of realized that you had to address after going through just a little bit of this, and what are you doing with your room now?
Yeah, just realizing how important the room environment is as well, you know, speaker placement and sound absorption and soundproofing. And I just realized that my room wasn't up to scratch. So I decided, you know what, I'm just going to have to do something about that. So right. I'm doing a reno. You can probably see some frame.
A little bit of 2x4s, yeah.
Yeah. So I'm, pretty much just starting from scratch and getting this room hunky-dory and ready to create some beautiful stuff.
Good for you, man. That's awesome. Yeah, I mean, so you're attacked from all these sort of different angles, right? There's sort of like the content, there's action items, you know, there's talking with me, there's the community as well. How has just the format of everything been for you in terms of how you've been able to apply yourself and what have you found beneficial just about the format itself?
For me personally, like I love just going on the Q&A calls. If I can't get there live, because it's hard because I'm in Brisbane, Australia sometimes and I've got to work as well, so I've got a full-time job.
Yeah.
But it's awesome that they're available to listen to after the fact. So I can just jump on there and just see what you're talking to others about and just really learn from those experiences and try and apply that to what I'm doing here. Like there's always something I'm like, oh yeah, that's, I can use that. Or there's a question that's like, well, I don't need to ask that because it's been asked and like,
right.
it's just there already.
Right. Yeah, so you've been able to sort of stay.
No, I'm sorry.
It seems like you've been able to stay on the sidelines and sort of listen and learn and just be able to apply based off of just kind of osmosis, just being kind of around.
Yeah, sure. And like once I've got my room finished, I'm keen to jump on in there and get some feedback from others and see what you think, especially.
For sure, man. Yeah. I mean, so you're kind of not through the entire process, right? But you're not just starting out. So I guess give a little bit of a picture about kind of what you've been able to sort of identify and see, and I guess already see improvements on about where you're at currently, because you're, you know, people probably think, okay, like what can you expect in terms of just like kind of what starts to change as soon as you dive in? And so I guess where are you at? What have you been able to do? And are you listening to things differently now? I mean, what's changing?
Yeah, definitely. I'm currently working on a project with some of the team from church and just being able to apply what I've learned into that situation. Like I'm coming from what does this need to be like to be awesome for the
right
for the mastering and the end product? And like, so instead I'm doing things thinking about what the end product's going to be, and also the way things sound as well, like especially that, you know, sonic frequency range and balance and where everything sits. It's, I'm starting to really connect with where that is and what it should be like, and yeah, getting more confident in that.
For sure, man.
If that makes sense.
Of course. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, so you have a lot ahead of you, right? I mean, you've already seen, you know, kind of how you're being able to apply a lot of stuff, but I guess, what are you most looking forward to? Obviously your room, we worked on getting your room to a place where it needs to be and you dove head first. What are you most looking forward to, or maybe a couple of things you're looking forward to as you're going to start progressing?
Well, I've already jumped the gun and I've already started my own mastering business. So,
dang, there you go.
I've already like got a domain name and email happening, and I'm just getting prepped for a website. So I'm like confident that at the end of this, I'm going to be a mastering engineer.
Amazing. Oh my gosh. I mean, yeah. And so you've got a lot ahead of you in terms of the content to be able to accelerate that, but you've jumped the gun and you're like, okay, I'm doing this. It sounds like you dove head first, man, which is just so exciting. That's awesome. That's cool, man. What's it called? If you don't mind me asking.
Kingdom Sound Mastering.
Oh, that is so cool, man. I want any merch that you get. This is what I tell everybody who like starts their own business. Any merch that you get, just send it to me because I rep it. So that is so cool.
Yeah, for sure.
I love it, man. Well, that's just fantastic. In terms of maybe, what would you say to those who are sort of maybe on the fence, maybe they've had a conversation with me and they're like, I don't know whether or not this is the right way to do anything to do with mastering, or maybe they're like not really sure if they should dive in or not. I mean, what would you say to them and what would your recommendation be?
Yeah, I'd definitely say just go for it. And once you take that step and do it, you'll just love it. And I've just been so fortunate to be able to learn things that I didn't think that, like I'm getting a little bit older in age and I'm still learning. And so if you're young, go for it. If you're old, go for it. It's just, yeah, it's awesome.
I love it, man. Yeah. It's been so cool. Just, I loved chatting with you the first time we chatted, and I'm excited to continue working with you on this. And I just think that there's some really awesome things in your future. And so I'm obviously 100% committed to partner with you, man, like one-on-one to get this, whatever it may be, whether it's with your church or whether it's your own music or whether it's the mastering engineering business, like I'm just committed to partnering to accelerate that process. So I'm very, very excited to see how you've come so far. And then as you continue to go, I'm excited to see what's next. So that's fantastic, man. I guess.
Yeah, for sure. I'm keen too.
Sure, man. I mean, you've got a lot of experience as a musician and as an engineer as well. And what's one piece of kind of knowledge or wisdom that you'd like to impart either to kind of your younger self or somebody who's maybe 5 or 6 steps behind you as a producer? I mean, do you have any sort of like one bit of kind of advice or knowledge that you'd like to pass down?
Definitely don't think that you know it all, or don't assume that you know what's best or what's right. Like if I could speak to my younger self, it would definitely be a bit more vulnerable and just listen and learn and take a step back instead of thinking that you know everything about every, I don't know.
Yeah, for sure.
I'll get tongue-tied.
I wholeheartedly agree with you. Like I just got so much to learn as well. And so like any type of success, I guess, if you will, relatively speaking, or like improvement that I've seen, it's always come from a direct correlation and causation because I've chosen to humble myself and say, okay, I don't know everything here. So I totally, totally agree with you, man.
Yeah, that's for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Is there anything else you'd like to share or say? And if not, that's totally cool too.
Oh, just thanks too. Like, thanks for putting this out there. I really think it's such awesome content, and yeah, like I know it's a little bit, to outlay some money to start with, but yeah, it's just really awesome stuff.
Yeah, man. I'm excited to just to see your progress. Like I said, I'm so excited that we're working together on this. And like I said, I'm fully committed to pouring into you, your music, and your business. I can't wait to see what comes about from it. And I also can't wait to see the final product of your room. That'll be cool.
Yeah, I'm excited about that. It's all coming together. We're doing some more work this weekend, so hopefully get it finished soon.
I love that, man. Yeah, I saw that time lapse on the community post and I was like, oh my gosh, this is awesome. So I was really excited to see that. Thanks so much for chatting and jumping on this, man. I sincerely appreciate it, man, for real.
Yeah, no worries.